So now y'all come into my kitchen. This is cooking today. Hi, welcome to cooking today. Happy Wednesday to you. Are y'all getting the itch to fall bake? I love fall baking. I love warm flavors and smells, and I like warm, hot, baked, yummy, rich desserts. And I actually just had a little side thought. I've been trying to watch what I've been eating. So this one I'm gonna have to save my calories for because it's so good, but it's rich. And this casserole, y'all, it just makes me think of fall and warmth and home and cool mornings. It is a cinnamon sugar French toast casserole with a blackberry fruit syrup. Does that sound so delicious to you? Oh my goodness. It just makes me think of crisp mornings, like Saturdays, maybe before a Razorback game or having company in town and being able to put this out and then coming home later that night, maybe pulling it back out of the refrigerator and heating it for a little bite of sweet at night. This little cinnamon sugar French toast casserole, y'all, it will just scratch all of your sweet itches for sure. It's so good. Now, let me tell you this right off the bat. The blackberry syrup is sweet and yum. It can actually be made ahead of time and stored in your fridge, which makes it great for company weekends, doesn't it? When we always have my friends from Dallas who come in for the Razorback games in the fall, I love to have a little something like this sitting on the counter or in the fridge ready to go whenever we just get that itch for something sweet to eat. And like I said, this is the kind of casserole that is so great that you can just set it out in the mornings and everybody can kind of eat however much or however little and, you know, kind of whenever they want to eat it. You can eat it hot right out of the oven or it can kind of sit and they can reheat it. It just does so many great things. And I generally make the blackberry syrup with blackberries. That's why I call it blackberry syrup. I could not with frozen blackberries, but my grocery didn't have frozen blackberries today, so we're gonna make it with blueberries. I really think you could do it with any fruit, as a matter of fact, and I'm gonna show you how in a minute. So whatever you have frozen in your freezer or whatever is available to you, you can make this really great little fruit syrup, okay? Now, like with most bread puddings, we start with a loaf of bread. And this really does, this French toast casserole really does nod toward a bread pudding, which is why I said in the beginning it's so, so rich and worth every calorie. And what we started with was just a bakery loaf of French bread. It's usually about a 14 and a half ounce, 15 ounce loaf. And I cut it into half, about inch, 3/4 of an inch slices. Turn those slices over and then just quarter them. Y'all just watched me do that. Really simple. And I put those down in a big bowl. And they're gonna sit here while I make the really delicious, creamy, sweet, juicy cream that's gonna go all over them. This sauce, ugh, is outstanding. Now, what I have is 8 large eggs. And I have these in a bowl. I like to do this in a bowl that has a pour spout because we're gonna pour it all over that bread and let it soak. So I have chosen to use one of my batter bowls. So I am going to just break these eggs up really quickly until they're really, really nice and combined. You don't want, once you start pouring all this other cream and all the vanilla and good stuff in it, you don't want there to be an egg yolk that got away from you. You really want to be sure your eggs are incorporated so that you don't have like a sunny side poached egg down in the middle of your really good dessert. Because I think that's exactly what it would do. So I think we are good on our eggs. Now, y'all, it's so good. Remember I told you at the beginning, I warned you. Calories and the flavor and the fat and the sugar and all the good stuff. You're gonna love this. We have a cup of sugar. We wait all summer long eating like fresh fruit, don't we? So that we can eat like this in the fall. It's gonna make you wanna have a fire in the fireplace and, you know, a good quilt, something good on TV at night, like a good football game, like on a Saturday night. I love those nights. So I am gently incorporating my sugar into my eggs. We want it to be nice and smooth. We want the sugar to dissolve so that we don't have anything gritty in our French toast casserole. So I think it feels good. I can feel it with my whisk that everything has gotten really nice and smooth. And then we're gonna add in 2 whole tablespoons of vanilla. And y'all, if you spill a little in, it's not gonna hurt a soul. You really shouldn't even have to measure this. I'm gonna do a little more for good measure, because who doesn't love the vanilla? I mean, right there, the vanilla is outstanding. My favorite smell of all. Don't I always whiff this? I do every time I open it. It just smells so good. Okay, I'm gonna whisk the vanilla in. When we come back, we're gonna add in our cream, a little cinnamon. We're gonna soak our bread, and we'll start on our fruit syrup that's gonna go beautifully sweet and tangy over this creamy bread pudding. This is Cooking Today. Hi, welcome back. If you're just joining us, we're making cinnamony, sugary, sweet French toast casserole with a really rich, sugary, warm fruit syrup that's gonna go on top. And when I say syrup, I mean maple syrup mixed in with some berries that we've cooked down and stewed with some sugar. It's delicious. It's warm from the maple syrup. It's tart and fruity from the fresh fruit. It is over the top good. We are letting our berries thaw. We did some frozen berries today, usually about a pound, 3/4 of a pound. You don't have to get super caught up on that. I'm just letting them thaw on my stovetop right now. Just hanging out. They're not on heat or anything. We're just gonna let them kind of knock some of the chill off. Then in our bowl, we have our eggs, our sugar, and our vanilla, and it just smells like something you could almost drink. Don't, but it smells like it. Then I have some cinnamon, good quality Vietnamese cinnamon. And I'm gonna do a pretty heaping teaspoon of cinnamon in my egg mixture. Oh, that right there, y'all, that is fall to me. It is fall to me. It just smells so warm. And it just makes me think about growing up at my house. My mother always made us cinnamon toast. Did y'all eat cinnamon toast? It was such an easy, quick breakfast to make. And it was something that we would eat a lot for just a little, almost like a little dessert. Just love it. And so the smells of cinnamon and sugar always make me think of growing up and my mom making that for us. Why is it mom's French or cinnamon toast is always better than anything I can ever make? Do you feel like that sometimes? When your mom makes you a sandwich, it tastes better than when you make it for yourself. So we have all of our good flavor in here. We've got all that good stuff and it smells so good. And we've got, now we're gonna pour in, starting to cream it up. This is 2 cups of whole milk. We're gonna whisk in. That cinnamon kind of floats to the top and has a tendency to wanna kind of clump a little bit. And I just make sure that I get my whisk in there and break it up real well. And then we're going with the heavy stuff, y'all. This is the hardcore stuff. 1.5 cups of heavy cream. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness. We have our bread, our whole loaf of French bread, camped out waiting because we're about to pour this delicious cream, this warm, sweet cream all over that bread and let it soak. Oh, y'all, so good. And this is easy. Isn't this so simple so far? We cubed a loaf of bread and we've basically just measured some cream and cracked some eggs and some sugar and vanilla. I mean, it's so, so simple to make. I think people get real intimidated sometimes about a bread pudding or something of this nature, you know, kind of a custardy dessert. You really don't have to worry about it at all. Okay. Y'all, oh, I wish you were here. It's delish. Oh, you know what? Let's do a little pinch of salt. Just the littlest pinch, maybe 1/2 teaspoon or so, just because it helps kind of offset that crazy, crazy sweetness. Yeah, I'll just give it a little spin. Now, here's our big bowl of our loaf of bread that we've cubed, and here this goes. I'm gonna smell it one more time. Oh my goodness. It smells like a good coffee. You know, like a really good fall coffee. Okay, here we go. Pouring, pouring, pouring all over the bread, all over the top, over every single piece. And this bread is starting to sink. I mean, it immediately starts to feel heavy with that liquid, and you can watch that whole pile go like that. It's relaxing because it's so glad to be soaked in this mixture. Now, let's see. I'll get this little guy. Now, I'm going to, you know, all the liquid is down in there. I'm going to make sure that all of this bread is tossed in the cream. Okay. Oh, my word. And then, just making sure, all the pieces, I'm eyeballing every piece to be sure that we're covered. Then what we're going to do is I'm kind of taking the back of my little utensil here and kind of pressing. I'm not smashing it down to pieces because I do want the bread pieces to still kind of have their, kind of hold their shape. But I'm going to just kind of get it down in there as far as I can. And then we're going to let it sit, okay? Sit. We're going to let it sit for 10 minutes or so. Let those pieces that are down in the bottom get really nice and soaked. Then I'm going to get in here with my utensil. We're going to flip it all around to make sure that the parts that are on the top get nice and covered in our liquid on the bottom, because everybody needs a turn soaking in that good cinnamony vanilla cream. And so we're going to let that do that for just a little bit. I am going to start to juice some lemons, because we're going to start working on our fruit syrup right here. So I'm going to go ahead and start juicing these guys. When we come back, we're going to work on our syrup and stick this in the oven. It's going to be a good day. This is Cooking Today. Hi, welcome back to Cooking Today. We are making cinnamony sugary sweet French toast casserole. Now, what I mean by that is, you know, generally we're kind of doing the same things as French toast, which is when you take a good kind of hearty, sturdy bread and you dip it and you soak both sides of a slice in a creamy, sugary vanilla mix, and then we skillet it and get that good little crisp on the outside and tender on the inside, and then pour delicious warm syrup over it. So in theory, same flavors, different method. So if you love the flavors of a cinnamon sugar French toast or cinnamon sugar toast, anything like that, this is what we're doing. But the beauty of a casserole like this is you bake it all at once and then it can all be served at once. French toast is a little bit more short order. You know, you kind of stand and make a couple of slices and put it on a plate and make another couple of slices and put it on a plate. And it's a little bit more constant work as opposed to this. We've kind of set it and forget it. We're gonna bake it and forget it. It's a lot easier to get that same great warm fall flavor without all the babysitting. Isn't that nice? So let me tell you what we've got here. We have our bread soaked in this delicious cream, y'all. It is warm and cinnamony. That cinnamon in there is the best. Splurge on your cinnamon. If you can find Vietnamese cinnamon or order it online, do it. It is different. It's so much warmer and more fragrant and richer. You're going to love it. It is noticeably different in this particular cream mixture. This has a few more minutes to sit and get soggy wet. And we're going to work on our sauce here. So you can use a pound of blackberries. You can use blueberries. You could probably try peaches if you wanted to do peaches. You could probably do strawberries if you wanted a strawberry sauce. What is so simple about this is you have any fruit. I use frozen because it's a little sturdier. And I've got some blueberries in a pot. I juiced a couple of lemons to get about 4 tablespoons or so of liquid in here. You don't have to get super hung up on this part. It's very forgiving. So whatever juice you get is great. You want just about enough to kind of cover the bottom of your pan, if that helps at all. Then we have sugar, about a quarter of a cup or so. Stir that around. Just stir that around. So we have a real sugary, lemony juice on our berries. And then watch how complicated this is. We're gonna move it to the stove, bring it to a boil, and let that just cook. And you wanna stir it, but you don't wanna smash your berries up. We're not looking for something smooth or pureed. We want a little bite, like a little chunky blackberry or a little chunky blueberry in there. So just let them kind of cook down and stir them real gently. At the end, all we're gonna do is stir in some maple syrup. It's delicious, y'all. And then you can even put it in a jar, make that a couple of days in advance, put it in a jar, and then you don't even have to mess with that on your morning that you may have company here. This would be great for a holiday morning as well, when you have a lot of cooking to do in the day, but you don't wanna have to get up and kill yourself to make this. Make breakfast for everybody. Make it the night before and then just set it back out and let everybody just kind of reheat whatever portion they want. That's 4 tablespoons of butter. Isn't that a beautiful sight right there? Okay, now, let me tell you what we need to do here on our pans. Before you go too far in this, you need to be intentionally choosing your pans. We're going to bake this in a water bath. And what a water bath is your pan that's gonna be full of your goods needs to be able to sit down inside a pan that is a little bit larger. And then we're gonna run hot tap water in the side of this pan. We'll do it in a minute. Where it comes up just about halfway up the side of the pan that you're baking your goods in. And so choose these first before you get going and before you butter a pan that you realize that you can't set it down inside something else. So be mindful right off the bat to choose your pans well, okay? So I'm taking this butter. This is important. You know, oftentimes I will say, you know, salted, unsalted butter, doesn't really matter. In this case, you really do want to have a very, very soft, unsalted butter because we really don't want there to be salty butter in here. We want this to be really, really sweet. And so I just smear those tablespoons all around the sides and all in the bottoms. Look, isn't that a beautiful sight? Nice and covered. That butter is going to help cook this. It's going to help it get a little crispy around the outsides. You are not gonna believe how delicious this is. Okay, look how simple. We're pouring all of the liquid, all of that bread down inside our prepared buttered pan. We're gonna take our spoon and just kind of spread it all around nice and evenly. Cover this with foil. Bake it at 350 for about 25 minutes, 30 minutes. Take the foil off. And then continue to bake it at just 15 minutes or so till the top of it is nice and golden brown. We're gonna hit it with cinnamon sugar right before we put it in the oven. It's phenomenal warm fall baking, perfect for company. This is Cooking Today. Welcome back. We're just finishing up this unbelievably delicious, sugary, sweet, cinnamony, warm French toast casserole. All those things. It's in the air. We are loving the way that it smells in here. This is the greatest little casserole for company, for breakfast, for a little bite of sweet at night, you name it, whatever. It is so good for your fall. With everybody coming into town for Razorback games and all that, what we've done is we baked our soaked, yummy, creamy bread in a buttered dish in our water bath. We covered it with foil, baked it for about 20 minutes or so, 30 minutes, took the lid off, and then we baked it uncovered. And then all we do is pick that up out of that water bath, Move it over here very carefully and let that cool for about 10 minutes or so. It needs to be crispy a little bit on the top, dried out just the littlest, but then still really nice and custardy on the inside. Then we have our hot, syrupy fruit that we cooked down on our stove, and it's still hot, and all we're gonna do is stir in about a cup and a half of maple sugar to this. And when this is ready to go, when we can spoon it, we're gonna put it in great deep bowls with pretty spoons, and we're gonna serve it right up. If you're feeling like it, you could do a little bit of ice cream, you could even do a little bit of sweetened, like cinnamon whipped cream. All the good things about fall, don't we love it? I hope that this serves lots of good purposes in your home this season. Love every bite. This is Cooking Today.